Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Mars coming at you over the interwaves with another StarCraft 2 cast, and I have put out a call for a new intro. So if you can think of something more useful for me to say rather than coming to you over the interwaves, of course you're coming to you over the interwaves, you're a fucking YouTube or Twitch if you're here live. Today, we have a TVZ on Echo Ladder Edition, a possible fight for the ages between Serial, who plays for Hush, with vertical brackets. His opponent is a barcode, Terran. So, you know, lots of personality on this side of the map, and, you know, a guy who named himself after what my wife eats for breakfast over here. So, you know, that's exciting. TVZ on Echo. Gee, what can I say? Wouldn't really give it in gigantic favor on either. Of course, going from the third base to the main base as a Terran, slightly easier as a Terran. So, especially if you're doing that in the 2-1-1. Well, in this case, I would have to do it like that. Very early on, where your opponent doesn't have the army to split off into two specific groups, that is a major pain to deal with. But getting a third base where if you take down this cooling tower is only accessible from one side, very nice depending on your playstyle. If you're a run-by sort of guy, then you don't want to have that. Well, mostly you don't want your opponent to have that, but I'm sure you get my drift. Serial starts with a hatch first, and the barcode Terran is playing with one gas. Just kidding, a second. Now, the Reaper be staying back? Nope, is going to send that out. And Serial is going to be in just fine a position to deal with that. Six Zerglings in position. That pushes back the Reaper once or twice, and then those queens will be out, meaning that absolutely no. Oh, is he going to? Oh, he's going to go up. All right, that means the Zerglings are not in position, and he may actually get a little bit of damage done. Yes, nope, just get some flesh wounds. Oh, that is a nice time for a queen to pop, and he gets on out of there. Did pull out of that gas right there, so that tells I exactly what his opponent is up to. No early roach rushes, no early banelings. This is going to be just zerglings for now, and very sloppily gets that taken out. Serial, in the meantime, getting a nice position here, tells him that the natural is there, and this one tells him that the third isn't back there yet, but other than that, oh, well, there, no, doesn't see what's going on here. Nothing too dramatic, though. That reactor actually for bio units, or are we going to cast something else? We're going to build anything? Nah, I think he's going to switch that over. Or not. No, he's comfortable just not building anything out of there. Maybe deems it more important to get that wall off. There's the scouts. Serial sees everything he needs to know. And this guy does still have a lock on, which you can use. Wait, does he see that? Oh, he doesn't see that. No, that's nicely positioned right there. So, yep, sees all of this, sees the starport, sees that third base, so this overlord is going to go down. But Serial knows everything his opponent is up to, which is worth a 100 mineral investment just fine. So, 1-1-1 with a fast third. So that means he's safe from any major pushes. Say two medevacs with a whole bunch of marines in them, as has been quite popular in the meta for, what, 6 months now? So that you know, makes him feel good. Does have quite a few zerglings right there in, you know, which lets him be defensive. or, you know, offensive if he so chooses. And this, in the meantime, gets spotted by that. So he should be able to maneuver a couple of things in place on that third. Or what he could do is he could just, you know, distract his opponent by placing a whole bunch of banelings. Oh, and there's a tank there, and tanks versus banelings. Oh, that's a wall. Gentlemen, if you... Oh, that was a very nice baneling with a mine right there. If you're going to build a wall, close it. Ah, because these zerglings are going to get absolutely up into your shiz. Going to get all those SCVs transferred to the third base. Going to get all the SCVs over here. And if he's paying attention, no, the wall to that third is down. And this is not enough marines to kill these zerglings. And Serial on a very, very nice early lead. Killing 18 workers. And he's not done yet because there's two more here. This tank is going to get down to that, but two more supply depots should go up. And at the back of this, droned up some more. 57 workers. Serial is feeling just fine. Now there's three Orville commands, so there's mules, and I know what we all say about mules, but that is a fair bit of damage. Got his first upgrades coming on as well, and we have terror vehicle weapons. We don't have a second factory yet. There we go. Terran going for mech, which is going to mean that he's going to be fairly vulnerable for the next 2-3 minutes. But after that, if he turtles up correctly, he can very much get back into this game if he so chooses. Serial just working on a little bit of his creep sped. I would like it if he could, you know, connect his main, especially if, you know, if you're facing a Terran who tends to, you know, somehow magically appear out of the middle of you know, the darkness and drop a whole bunch of stuff in there. You want to shoot them down with your queens, then they have to waddle over this area right there. Anyway, one zergling here, spotting for that possible fourth, and nothing right there to spot for that fourth over there. Serial feels comfortable enough to take his own fourth. All right, that 2-3 minute window is slowly closing down, getting a macro hatch right there, right on the front line there, and a spire as well. Serial getting another 7 banelings, getting more zerglings, getting those centrifugal hooks. Has got that 1-1. Has he started 2-2? Has not started 2-2 quite yet. Does he have a... Yes, he does. Yes, he does. There is 2-2 as well. So, yeah. Should be very comfortable with that. That doesn't give him any scouting information whatsoever. He just sees a Widow Mine here and a bunch of Liberators there. Doesn't see... I suppose you can call this more what you don't see. You don't see a whole bunch of Marines sitting here, which is normally where you'd expect him to be. And because Serial has, you know, quite good map awareness with that creep, you should push this up here, but there you go. With those overlords right there, he knows that there isn't an army of the Terran, you know, floating around here somewhere. He knows this, so there's not a whole bunch of Marines. You don't keep your Marines in here, because why the hell would you? You want to be able to defend this location, and you want to be able to defend this location, and both of those are best done from here. So what does that mean? All right, the Zergling did get taken out, so he's just going to see whether that fourth has been taken, and yep. That's not something you can do with Zerglings. Take on Liberators and Liberation Zones. Instead, there is a shit ton of stuff here. Oh, and that is going to be one dead Widow Mine. And do we have anything that shoots up? Well, we have a Seeker missile. We have one Viking. We have one Liberator and two fours. Now, the two fours is what make this dangerous. He's got the turret right here, but this, on the other hand, shouldn't be too much. Oh, we're going to take out one Banshee. Does split right there. Nope, pull that back. Liberators don't do nearly the amount of splash damage that did anymore. And here comes the Zerg trade. Oh, that tank getting quite a nice shot off on those Banelings. And those Banelings are going to go. Where are those Banelings going? You want to either get the SCVs, get those SCVs. Yes, there you go. All right. Very nicely on 41 workers taken down right there. No, he doesn't get the Orbital Command Center. But he does reset that tank count. He does take out two Thors right there, I do believe. And make sure that his opponent needs to first consider resaturating this third before he starts thinking about taking a third. And this is, would be a good time to... Does you have this? You don't have Burrow. Just Burrow one of these there. Just be a dick. You're a Zerg player. That's what you're supposed to do. Did lose a lot of Mutalis by the look of it. 11. And there is a Merzel turret right there. And oh, there you go. And there's that takes out that Banshee. Not a Baneling. Banshee. And the ground forces once again get taken out, including the Thor once again. And that means we just have Vikings and just Vikings against Mutalis. Aren't the greatest thing ever. I mean, they'll deal with it. They have superior range, not superior maneuverability. But they're better tools for dealing with Mutalisks. Well, let me just say that. All right, so have we gone to Hive yet? We haven't gone to Hive yet. We built even an infestation pit. No, we haven't. We are on two... Wait, what? I don't even know what this is. The Seeker Missile Damage. I have never seen this upgrade used. What are you doing? The Sardic Energy of Raven. So, one of the turtling tools of Terrans, Mass Raven. And it looks like the Terran is looking to go into just that. Going to lose one Viking, going to lose two Viking. And there again are those Zerglings. Yes, Hellbats do fantastic against Zerglings, but only if they're just not quite that badly outnumbered. Zerglings on a planetary fortress with quite that much repair is not going to go down great. That's going to cost him a lot of Zerglings. And this one got down in the meantime. So, yeah, if that doesn't get spotted, that means that our Terran player can't get in there just now. If you look at the resources lost. This is fine, by the way. If you keep your opponent on three bases, this is fine. Look at this. Well, so we still have six of them mineral patches out of eight. This is nothing. And just that one base. So if you make sure this doesn't start mining, which right now it is, and starting into a planetary fortress. Nope. Yep, fours once again. Oh man, yeah, if we can get this before that finishes, does force that lift off and takes out one Liberator, two Liberator, all of the Thors. Once again, the anti-air of the Terran player keeps getting absolutely decimated, and this planetary fortress should go down. Oh, even sending a couple of those Banelings into the SCVs that we're thinking about repairing. Is that actually going to go down? Is that going to go down? Yes, there we go. Making sure that he can do those run-bys he so wanted. Have we done Terran building armor? Yes, we have. That's why that took such a long time. And if you're going to be turtling with PFs, then I heartily recommend this. And somebody in chat can probably tell me whether this doesn't also somehow work on the turrets from the Ravens. The auto turrets. I don't know. These upgrades don't get done a lot. So then you just don't know unless you play the race. And then in the kind of style that requires lots of Ravens. Look at this creep threat, by the way. So this is the vision mineral of Serial. Expended. Oh, look. He's got Abathur. Oh, look at that range on that Thor. Is he gone? No, doesn't get that Raven. Does lose two or three Mutalisks right there for nothing. But, oh, here we go. Once again, moving on in with Zerglings, with Banelings, and Banelings and Zerglings cleaning up absolutely everything, even if it does take a little bit of time right there. And now there's just the Liberator with the Liberation Zone is going to get... Wait, did he not... Oh, this is the one. Sorry. 7 kills, but those are 7 Zerglings and or Banelings, which is just, you know... Considering the cereals economy, who's on 72 workers, and on 1, this is almost done, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that's not your base, 6 bases, you're fine, you can do that, you can throw this much more into your opponent than you want. Your opponent is on 3 bases. Ooh, that's a very nicely placed one right there. Are we going to get into that? We have no Banelings this time, so this might be just a little bit trickier. It is going to clean that up, including that auto turret. Nope, resets the tank count once again. Resets all of the Thor count as well. I do not believe there's any on the field just now. And Corruptors to deal with that anti-air threat does last a little bit longer than Mutalisk, so I can't say I blame him for that choice. Although sometimes you do use them to take care of Widow Mines, Mutalisk that is, and Corruptors don't do that at all. Alright, spreading that creep once again. 54 army supply versus 45. So despite all of this, the army supply is still quite comfortable. And like Peage. Nope. It is going to be in position to push that away. The first couple of seconds of this, 7 damage per second for 4.3 seconds. Then it's 35 damage per second. You can't outheal that with SCVs. That just doesn't work. Does not work. But look at this. This is the income that the Terran has. He has to keep this base. If he loses this base, and here come Ultras. Ultras quite good against pretty much everything he has here, except maybe, you know, Liberators. And, oh, no, no, there's nothing enough. There's not enough left. He doesn't have any Zerglings to buffer. He doesn't have any Banelings to roll on in there and blow up the Widow Mines as they blow up the Banelings, which is just about the best thing ever. And that means that this base is going to go up. Ooh, and he has spotted this base, and there's nothing here to defend these drones. So Cyril has to pull that away. Is that that first Banshee? No. No, 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 that is the second Banshee. Alright, moves in a couple of Zerglings, and that Ultralisk is going to do fairly better against that thing right there. Everything else, on the other hand, not going to fare that well. Nope, we have no detection, so that Banshee can just... wail away on that Ultralisk. That Ultralisk is going to survive, which is just fine. And should take out that. This base is just fine. He could probably take this base. Does he know about this yet? Yeah, well, he knows about it now. Could not choose to take this there. And do you have anything that shoots up? How much energy do you have? You still have quite a bit of energy, but your opponent has detection. Oh, this does so much damage to Mutalisk, and they do absolutely bugger all damage on Overlord. A little bit of a run by over here. So, you know, 2 workers versus 65. Getting there. Very slowly getting there. And his run by does get cleaned up. Once again, has a run by over here, and he still hasn't built any static D over here, which means that this should take... quite a bit of damage. There you go. Building that static D. And look at that energy on the Raven he's willing to expend. Alright, so Cyril's having a little bit of an issue closing this out. Oh, does get another little bit of a giveaway. And is going to take this down just to make sure he has the mobility to move and dash from base to base. That creep threat got pushed right the way back, by the way. Okay. So, 90 army supply versus 96. And what are we going to do? Well, this base still hasn't been taken. Ooh, yes, takes that out before it burrows, and now we have quite a bit of air force right there. So that is one widow mine, and now you can clean that up. Don't use your bailings. Yes, just in time. Still hasn't taken up this, and is going to get a flank on this army right here. And the Terran is moving away. He's moving away. That made that just the first bit of his army engaged the army of Cyril right there before. Oh, those are a lot of mines. That's a lot of mines. Unfortunately, mines not the greatest thing against Ultralisks. So there you go. What are is very good against Ultralisks are Thors. Thors do very well against Ultralisks. If, on the other hand, you have two Thors, and there are more... Oh, that's very nice split right there. If there are more Ultralisks, then you are going to have a bad time. This army did... Oh, is that going... Is that... Oh, if that had recharged just a little bit earlier, that could have gotten a very juicy shot. Once again, completely dead... well, as I said, not the best return on investment right there. 71 versus 42. He's still mining, but it's just the one base. This is empty. This is empty. And he is actually flying it in over here. So this base is not going to be a planetary fortress. So Cyril, if he's on point, should be able to deny this base. And the Terran can't afford to place a planetary fortress there. So what he does instead is build a whole bunch of widow mines there. And oh, he's actually long distance mining off there. If he can get a sneak a couple of zerglings in there, that would be very nice. All right, we got the blinding cloud coming on in there on the anti-air thing. And oh no, evacuating all those SCVs, leaving the planetary fortress to stand on its own. Does quite a bit of damage. Oh, there go the SCV into the mouths of death. Does still do quite a bit of damage to the planetary fortress, but it does go down. And that means that, oh, what's happening over here? We've got Raven Arras. Raven Arras and Blue Flame Hellions Arras. Nope, Blue Flame Hellbat Advance. Advance Arras. Debate dive over here. Much the same going on, but it's not being controlled. So Static D wins out there. Have you built Chitinous Plating? Yes, you have. All right, very good. 5 damage. Yeah, 5 armor, even. 48 to 93. And yeah, Cyril by now. Well, he's got 2 mining bases, so that's better. Retaking this one over there, just making sure that this one isn't being taken. Takes out a free liberator. Well, and make sure that order of command is very much of the mind that nope, let's not do any of that. And here's the turn. Going to be able to decimate the workers of Cyril, but that is going to cost him that army. And this, oh, doesn't split his the parasitic bombed Vikings. And now we're down to 30 army supply versus 100 of the Zerg. And if he just gets this, and he does know that this has been taken. No! No, he doesn't! Right. Where is that Raven that keeps doing that? Cyril doesn't know about this base. And Cyril's not going to get creeps right here in time to deal with that. Alright, now, 3 widow mines is not going to be the greatest thing ever. Oh, but if it takes care of your detection, that would be bad. And here are Ultralisks in your bases. There's none left in the air to counter those corruptors. There's nothing at all left to deal with the Ultralisks. And GG. If you enjoyed this video, press that like button. If you'd like to see more of me, subscribe.